Hello students, in this video we will discuss about wave angle, oblique tilt angle and phase velocity and group velocity. So this is the parallel plane waveguide and these are the two metallic plates. One plate is at x is equal to 0 and another plate is at x is equal to a, and this is the EM wave source, and the wave is propagating in this way. So this angle theta is called as wave angle. The phase constant along the propagation direction is beta, but the phase constant along the guide axis is beta bar. And we already discussed gamma bar. It is equal to under root of m pi by a whole square minus omega square mu epsilon. If we take minus common, under root of minus is j, so j under root omega square mu epsilon minus m pi by a whole square. So gamma bar, it is equal to j into beta bar. So beta bar, it is equal to under root of omega square mu epsilon minus m pi by a whole square. So from here we can calculate the phase velocity along the guide axis, which is equal to omega divided by beta bar. It is omega divided by under root omega square mu epsilon minus m pi by a whole square. And the phase velocity Vp, it is equal to omega, and we have taken common omega under root mu epsilon under root 1 minus m pi by a omega under root mu epsilon whole square. Okay, so omega will cancel, and 1 by root mu epsilon, it is c, so we have put here c, and omega c, which is a cutoff frequency, it is m pi c by a. So m pi, and this is c, m pi c by a, this is omega c, so this is omega c by omega whole square. So this is one of the very important formula for phase velocity, and this is c upon under root of 1 minus omega c by omega whole square. This is the phase velocity along the guide axis. We also know that beta bar, it is equal to beta into cos theta. Beta bar, it is 2 pi by lambda bar. Beta, it is 2 pi by lambda into cos theta. Lambda bar, it is wavelength along the guide axis, and lambda bar, it is equal to lambda upon cos theta. So lambda bar f, we are multiplying with f. Lambda bar f, it is equal to lambda into f into cos theta. So lambda bar f, it denotes vp. Vp is the phase velocity along the guide axis. Lambda into f, it is c, right? C upon cos theta. So vp is equal to c upon cos theta. So it is c upon under root of 1 minus omega c by omega whole square. It is c upon under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square. So when we compare, then this cos theta is equal to under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square. So we can put here sine theta. We can calculate the value of sine theta. Sine theta will be equal to fc by f, where theta is called as tilt angle. So this is the formula of tilt angle or wave angle. This is sine theta is equal to fc by f, where theta we can calculate sine inverse fc by f. Theta is tilt angle. So in a waveguide, every frequency has unique tilt angle, unique velocity along guide axis, which is not shared by other frequencies. It is called as FDMA. FDMA is called as frequency division multiple excess. So Vp is c upon cos theta, but cos theta, mod of cos theta, we know it varies from 0 to 1, mod of cos theta. So from here we are observing Vp greater than c, but according to Einstein's relativity theory, it is not possible. Actually Vp is along the guide axis, is not the actual velocity. Actual velocity in this case is the group velocity, which is due to multiple reflections and multiple waves. So group velocity we define d omega by d beta bar. It is the differentiation of omega with respect to beta bar. So beta bar, it is equal to omega under root of omega square mu epsilon minus m pi by a whole square. So d beta over d omega, it is, we can differentiate it. When we will differentiate, it is 1 upon 2 under root omega square mu epsilon minus m pi by whole square into 2 omega mu epsilon. So d beta over d omega, it is equal to this 2 and 2 will cancel. So this is omega mu epsilon upon omega under root mu epsilon and under root of 1 minus m pi by a omega under root mu epsilon whole square. So d beta over d omega, it is 1 upon c, right? It is when this will cancel. So here under root of mu epsilon will be there, and 1 by root 2 mu epsilon, it is equal to c. So this is 1 upon c under root 1 minus omega c by omega whole square. But the group velocity vg, it is d omega over d beta bar, it is equal to it's reciprocal. So when we will reciprocal it, so it is c into 1 minus under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square. So we are getting vg is equal to c into cos theta, and practically vg less or equal than c, which is practically possible. Because mod of cos theta is between 0 to 1, so vg is less or equal than c. So here we are getting vp into vg. When we product this two, phase velocity and group velocity, we are getting c square. So c is under root of vp into vg. So this is also important for us, and some numericals has come into the examination from this relationship. Thank you for watching the video.